Well, the six children who came in close contact with a child who died of bacterial meningitis were in school today and are doing well tonight. Sunday morning, six-year-old Vshanti Washington died of bacterial meningitis. She's just one of the 3,000 Americans to die from the disease every year. Today, 16 WAPT's Catherine Kite spoke with a man who survived the disease. Catherine.
Brad, you don't hear a lot about bacterial meningitis or what it can do to you, but it's the most serious form of meningitis, and it can lead to other complications that can essentially burn you from the inside out. That's exactly what happened to the man you're about to meet.
I feel for that little girl. I hate that happened to her. You know, cause I'm grown and older and barely could take it. So I know she just went through a rough time.
The story about the death of Vshanti Washington by bacterial meningitis brought back memories for Larry Bracey. He contracted the disease in April 2008. And just like Vashanti's case, he went from having cold symptoms to near death in a matter of hours. These scars on his body are from skin grafts. While fighting the disease, he also developed sepsis, a very bad infection that essentially burnt him from the inside out.
Pure pain for about 4 months, you know, until I started, you know, getting a little better. But even now, I still hurt, and it's still hard on me to deal with it physically and mentally.
Also like Vshanti, doctors don't know where Larry contracted the disease. 5 to 10% of the population carries the bacteria in the back of their throat and can infect others without even knowing it. It's transferred by coughing, sneezing, or close contact with another person.
And the CDC recommends people 11 to 18 years old get vaccinated for bacterial meningitis. But children as young as 2 can get the vaccination. And to learn more about this disease, just visit our website at WAPT.com and look under the As Seen On section. Brad.
Thank you.